like to show you here. This is more Scottish than bagpipes, tartan, haggis and heroin put together.
In this Scottish comedy club, no topic is off limits.
I love how fucking heroin's getting a laugh in this room, eh? That's your fucking level, is it? You're all sedated right now, is that what it is, eh?
And jokes about their closest neighbour are common.
Like, secretly, we want England to win because we fucking love misery in this country, do you know what I mean?
It's the first time since the start of the pandemic that English tourists are visiting this club.
You have 15 months of the city to yourself, walking around, thinking it's some sort of utopia. You're walking around going, this is what independence will be like. Not happening.
But here, north of the border, talk of independence is no joke.
I'm here in Edinburgh, Scotland, where the Scottish National Party has just won a record fourth term in power. After centuries of struggle and in the wake of Brexit and the pandemic, many people are now asking, could this be Scotland's long-awaited chance for independence?
Now, 1984, underneath that church, James, they discovered some vaults.
Daniel Downie is a stand-up comedian by night. By day, he's a history scholar and one of Edinburgh's most popular tour guides.
Now, in the year 1707, the Act of Union was ratified here at Parliament Hall. That's the moment when Scotland became a part of Great Britain. In 2014, we had an independence referendum here in Scotland, whereby the people of Scotland, they were asked whether they wanted to be an independent country for the first time in over 300 years. Now, in the end, 45% of the country voted for independence, 55% of the country voted against independence. And so Scotland remains a part of the United Kingdom, for the moment at least, anyway. Right, follow me, guys. Let's crack on. Right, Claire, I think I know what you're thinking here. This guy seems to talk a load of shite, but also seems to know what he's talking about.
While in the European Union, young Scots like Daniel enjoyed the injections of EU cash into deprived areas and the freedom to live, work and travel across the continent.
I think for the young people here in Scotland especially, they view their identity as European. I believe that a lot of people in Scotland would view themselves as Scottish and European as opposed to British and Scottish. Or, if they don't, the divide is there.
During Brexit, 62% of Scots voted to stay in the EU. So when the United Kingdom voted to leave the EU, many Scots felt their voice had been ignored. As a result, the Scottish National Party, or SNP, has vowed to hold another referendum on Scottish independence.
Scotland's future must be in Scotland's hands.
What Brexit has done is just shown the political divide that exists between the two countries, you know. England's a conservative country and always kind of traditionally has been. Scotland's always been more left-leaning. In the past, that used to be Labour. Now it's pretty heavy SNP. And it's just like we're going in two completely different directions. And Scottish people are just fed up of having a government that they don't vote for.
Daniel says in order to promote the union, London has even threatened to send the royals to spend more time here in Edinburgh.
Any person who thinks that the royals is going to change or sway people's opinion here in Scotland, for me, that shows the strength of the Yes movement, because that's a sign of desperation. If that's honestly what you're doing, Christ alive, it'll be Prince Andrew they'll be sending up next, you know what I mean? It's even worse than fucking the nuclear weapons they give us, you know? Like, my God. Probably more dangerous as well, to be fair, but